Exploring the Fractal Nature of Financial Markets through Hurst Exponent. The financial markets are a complex system, deeply entrenched in global economic systems, impacting nations, corporations, and individuals alike. Understanding these systems is of great interest to investors, traders, and economists. One key element of these systems is their fractal nature, which can be explored through the Hurst Exponent. The Hurst Exponent is a statistical measure used to classify time series data, including the financial market data. It is named after the British hydrologist H. Hurst, who first introduced the concept. The fractal nature of financial markets. Fractals, in mathematics, are patterns that are self-similar at different scales. They may be exactly the same at all scales, example, the Coke snowflake, or, as is often the case in nature, they may be nearly the same at different scales. The concept of fractals extends beyond shapes; it can describe processes and structures. The idea that financial markets might be fractal in nature was first proposed by mathematician Benoit Mandelbrot. He suggested that financial fluctuations are much better modeled by fractal geometry than by standard Gaussian distribution. This approach presents the financial markets as a complex system, in which patterns repeat at various scales. Understanding the Hurst Exponent. The Hurst Exponent, denoted as H, is a tool that helps determine the potential memory of a time series. Specifically, it quantifies the long-term memory of a time series, which is crucial in predicting the future values of that series. The Hurst Exponent ranges between 0 and 1. A time series with Hurst Exponent approximately 0.5 can be modeled as a random walk, no correlation. If H is significantly greater than 0.5, the series has positive autocorrelation, trend reinforcing, while if H is significantly less than 0.5, the series has negative autocorrelation, mean reverting. Applying the Hurst Exponent to financial markets. The Hurst Exponent provides valuable insights when applied to financial market data. For instance, the knowledge that a financial time series is trending, H is greater than 0.5, or mean reverting, H is less than 0.5, is a valuable piece of information for an investor or trader. Example 1, trading strategy for trending markets. Assume you've calculated the Hurst Exponent for the price of a particular stock and found that H equals 0.7. This indicates that the stock has a high degree of positive autocorrelation and is thus trending. In such a case, one might devise a trading strategy that takes advantage of this trending behavior by buying when the price dips slightly, anticipating that the long-term upward trend will continue. Example 2, trading strategy for mean reverting markets. On the other hand, if you calculated the Hurst Exponent for a different stock and found that H equals 0.4, this suggests negative autocorrelation or mean reversion. This means that increases in the stock's price are likely to be followed by decreases, and vice versa. In such a case, a possible strategy could be to sell the stock when its price significantly increases, expecting that it will soon decrease. Caveats and considerations. While the Hurst Exponent can provide valuable insights, it is not a silver bullet. Other factors such as macroeconomic indicators, company-specific news, and broader market sentiment can all cause sudden changes in market behavior that the Hurst Exponent might not predict. Additionally, calculating the Hurst Exponent requires a sufficient amount of historical data, which might not be available for all stocks or other assets. It's also worth noting that the Hurst Exponent is a statistical measure and, as with all such measures, it is subject to a degree of uncertainty. The fractal nature of financial markets offers unique insights into market behavior, providing traders and investors with another tool in their arsenal. The Hurst Exponent, in particular, can be a valuable resource in identifying trending and mean reverting markets. While it doesn't guarantee success and should be used in conjunction with other tools and knowledge, understanding and applying this measure can help market participants make better informed decisions.